Hi everyone, this video is about dealing with the negative terms in algebraic expressions and equations. Let's move to the whiteboard. We have discussed in the previous videos that an arithmetic expression is nothing but one or more variables and constants connected by an arithmetic operation. So it could be something as simple as a variable plus a constant, or it could be a complex relationship, something like y minus xy plus x into z minus 2. Both of these are arithmetic expressions. It connects variables and constants with arithmetic operations. Okay, while evaluating arithmetic expressions, the first step that you do is you can simplify the arithmetic expressions to be able to identify the terms. Though it's not a necessary step, but that will give you the picture of how many terms are there in the expression. And to simplify this expression, I will just open this bracket. So I'll multiply x to z and plus x. While you multiply two terms, you should take note of the sign of both the terms. So I'm multiplying plus x to plus z. It becomes x into z. And here I'm multiplying plus x to minus 2. So it becomes minus 2x. And now I have four terms here in this algebraic expression. The first term here is plus y. The next term is minus xy. The next term is plus xz, and then we have minus 2x. I can always rearrange the terms in an algebraic expression. Now that I have identified the terms, as long as I keep track of the signs. If I miss the signs, then I end up with a new expression. So I don't want to do any changes to the expression. I just want to rewrite it in another way. So I can rearrange the expression in any way. I can write this term first, minus 2x, and then I can say I want to write this term second. This is plus y, and then I want to write the term plus xz, and I want to represent this as the fourth term. So this term is minus xy. As long as I have moved the sign of the term along with the term while rearranging, the mathematical meaning of both of these expressions is same. This expression is equal to this expression. You can do any rearrangement within an algebraic expression as long as you move the term along with the sign. In an algebraic equation, which has an equal to sign. You have an algebraic expression on both sides of the equal. This is in the left hand side, you have an algebraic expression and you have an algebraic expression on the right hand side. And the equality sign connects the two expressions, saying that this expression is equal to this expression. So in such cases, and this is also called algebraic equation. Let's take an example. If I have an equation y plus x plus 2 equal to 0. In this case, if I am rearranging the terms, if I just look at the left hand side, there is an algebraic expression here. If I look at the right hand side, there is an algebraic expression here. There's no variable, but this algebraic expression just has one constant. it's a valid algebraic expression. So if I am rearranging the terms on either side of the equal to, on LHS or on RHS, then I can do the rearrangement similar to what we just discussed a minute ago, the rearrangement of terms in an algebraic expression. As long as I don't mess up with the signs and I move the sign of the term along with the term, then it's perfectly fine. I can write this as plus 2, plus y, plus x. I can rearrange it in any way as long as I am not moving anything from LHS to RHS. Within the LHS, I can do any rearrangement. However, if I want to move a term from LHS to RHS or RHS to LHS, then the sign would change. If I want to move this term plus 2 to RHS, it will become minus 2 on RHS. This will be minus 2. And a way to understand this would be to just take an example. We know that 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Yes. And if I want to hear in this algebraic expression, I mean, I know I can simplify this further, but without simplifying it right now, it has these two terms. And if I want to move this minus 1 to the other side, then I can write this as 3. This minus 1 would go to the RHS and it will become plus 1. So if you ever get confused, you can just write a numeric example and then it will make more sense. So in general, once I have simplified the equation, then I can move terms to LHS to RHS or RHS to LHS, and I will have to change the sign of the term. However, don't do this transition from LHS to RHS if there are brackets and if the algebraic expression on LHS or RHS is not simplified. So first simplify, remove all the brackets. For example, if I have something like this, let's say this is 2 into, this is y plus 2 into x minus 2 equal to 4. So in this case, I cannot move this minus 2 inside the bracket on the other side. No. I can either take this as one term, and from the previous videos, I hope you understand that each one term is separated from other term through a plus or minus sign. So I can consider this entire thing as one term and move this in entirety. I could do something like y is equal to 4 minus 2 into x minus 2. This is correct. Or I should just open this bracket, multiply this. So this becomes y plus 2x minus 4 equal to 4. This will become y plus 2x plus 2 into minus 2 will be minus 4 equal to 4. Now that this entire algebraic expression is in the form of terms, there are three terms. Now if I move any term from LHS to RHS, the sign will change. If I move this 2x to the other side, it will become, this y will remain here. It will become y minus 4 is equal to, I have not done any change to this 4, so this will remain here. I have just moved this 2x to the other side. So this 2x will go here and it will become minus 2x. Understanding this is important in solving algebraic equations. And we'll do another video on how to move things from LHS to RHS or RHS to LHS when things are multiplied. So in this case, we were only moving things which were added or subtracted. we were moving the entire terms. What if this entire expression here was multiplied by 2? How do we move this? Let's cover this in a new video. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for joining. Bye.